Hey everybody, this is Nick. I'm coming to you with a viewer question from one of our viewers, Benedict K 8228. Thanks, Benedict K 8228, for this question. This was on our video on how to make a jitter plot, a horizontal jitter plot in Excel. And he asked, they asked, is there a way to add the standard deviation to the average dot? And yes, there absolutely is a way to do that. And it's pretty easy too, Benedict. So let me go over to our workbook here. This is how I think it would look best. So we have our average dot right here, the custom average marker that we made in the video. And then we have this gray shaded area that represents the standard deviation. And that just comes from a calculation in Excel, the formula, the standard deviation formula or function there of our entire lot. I'm gonna go through and just let you know how I did this. So we created our jitter plot just like we did in the video. We have our custom average line right here with the label. First, I'm going to go ahead and calculate that standard deviation. So I'm just going to type in equals, and then this standard deviation, stdev.p, and I'm going to go ahead and point to the range. It's time we're using here. So the whole lot of all of the times that our visitors spent in the exhibit that we were visualizing there. And so there's our standard deviation in decimals, but we want it to be formatted in time as well. So all I'm going to do is just take one of my time cells over here. I'm going to push the format painter button and then format this cell the exact same way. So standard deviation is 9 minutes and 29 seconds for this data set. What I'm going to do here is I'm going to click on the average dot marker here, and now we're going to apply some error bars. So let's go over here to this Skittle here and click on that, and then click on error bars. What I'm actually going to do is I'm going to open the drop-down menu and click on more options because I want the format error bar menu to pop up. So you should see that over here on your right. And then you can also see the error bars that have appeared. We have horizontal error bars and we have vertical error bars. We don't need the vertical one, so those are selected. I'm just going to delete them, push backspace there. And then on the error bars here, instead of the default, we're just going to create custom lengths for them based on our standard deviation. So in order to do that, we're going to first say, I want both, so we're going to keep it at both. I'm going to say end style, no cap. And then instead of fixed value of 1, I'm going to go ahead and put in custom. And then I'm going to click on specify value, and it asks for the positive value and the negative value. I'm just going to go ahead and point to our standard deviation cell there for the positive and for the negative. We'll push enter and then OK. And now you can see our standard deviation has run about 9.5 minutes on either side of that average. Now, in order to format this, we just have to work with the line, the paint bucket over here on the format error bar menu. So I'm going to go ahead and let's make it kind of a lighter shade of gray, and then maybe even a little bit darker than that. See how that looks. And then under the width, it's 0.5 right now, but I'm just going to keep on pushing that up all the way until, you know, you get to what it kind of looks good to your eye there. And I think that looks kind of good. It encompasses most of the dots there, but it's a little too dark. So I think I'm going to go ahead and just make it a little bit lighter right there. Now, if you wanted to for here, now in order to label it, you could, add just a dummy dot here if you wanted the label to be totally embedded into the chart. But in this case, I think I would just do brute force and add a text box. So click insert and then add that text box right inside the chart. And then here, I'm going to go ahead and maybe make it pretty small here, 9-point font, and then just type in SD, or you could type in standard deviation. Let's go ahead and make it the same color as the line. We're going to make it bold. I guess I can turn it up a little bit. And then we'll just do that. And then make sure that that text box is set to no fill and no line, so it doesn't look like there's any extra fluff around there. So that looks really nice. So I think that's one of the ways that you could add standard deviation to this type of chart. I think you'd, depending on your reader or your audience, you definitely have to have them understand what that means and what that means for your chart. So you'd probably have to have some explanation in the narrative around it. But if your audience is familiar with something like standard deviation and they're looking for it in your chart, this is a way to do it. So I hope you like it. Thanks again for the question. I hope everybody else had a great time watching this. If you do, make sure to click the like button and the subscribe button and the bell next to it. You'll get notified every time I post a new video in data design, usually Excel, PowerPoint, or Word. I had a great time making this for you. If you have questions, feel free to comment on any of my videos, and I'll try to make a video that answers your question or point you to the resource that I think would be most helpful. Hope you all have a great day, and I can't wait to see you next time.